Stacks of Old Smoky are pouring out soot from the harbor in Salem to the towns on the Rut. The guys who make profits for Virginia's Dominion are running their business like hard-hearted men. They are sending out poisons and pollutants to boot, and as we die and sicken, they don't give a hoot.
I'm Dolores Jordan, and I live on 97 Derby Street. I've been concerned about the plant since the early 50s. I used to go to hearings to testify that the plant needed to take care of its their issues because they were polluting our environment.
We live with the visible, tangible effects of it. We all breathe the air. Essex County, that this plant is located in, gets an F for the quality of the air in it.
Since 2005, there have been 317 self-reported opacity violations. And what this means is these are violations that are the toxic particles emitted from the stacks that blanket the North Shore.
For they're counting their profits and the stockholder shares, and they're telling the press lies, thinking nobody cares.
And if you look behind you, you'll see that wooden pier, and that's where the coal ship from Columbia comes in. It looks as if it's about 10 to 11 stories high. It's huge.
The true cost of coal comes from above and it's strong. Subsidizing the impact is more than enough.
You know, there's 100,000 people within 3 miles of Salem that has to live with this toxic legacy.
We have people in the neighborhood that not only died from cancer, but like myself, have bronchial problems and breathing and that.
Almost every single day, I came by this plant with my little truth-telling camera and took a picture of emissions coming from the stacks there. And of course, they tell us, oh, it's just air, it's just steam, black steam. But of course, we have all the photos to show that it is not that. And thanks to CLF, they pointed out that it really was emissions that should not have been coming from those stacks.
Sorry, can you talk a little bit about why this plant wasn't required to upgrade and improve itself?
The plant owners and the lobbyists for the plant tell us all the time they are meeting just the letter of the law, supposedly, in terms of pollution requirements. Although CLF has pointed out that their emissions actually are in violation of current law.
In 2007, the Salem Harbor Station earned the EPA status of number 3 polluter in Massachusetts, emitting 276,000 pounds of pollutants into the air, and that's in 1 year.
There were ways to remedy the facts at the plant by putting in scrubbers years ago that may have cost maybe $150,000, but because they were grandfathered, they were able to get away with murder for all these years. Nobody wanted the plant to close. They just wanted them to use the resources that are on the market to clean up the plant.
In 2007, a tragic explosion at the plant killed 3 workers. The plant was closed for 6 months. It took 100 outside contractors to clean up the building, which was covered with debris and asbestos-laden ash. In 2010, the Clean Air Task Force compiled annual health statistics related directly to the power plant. In 2010 alone, this power plant was responsible for 10 deaths, 36 heart attacks, 310 asthma attacks, 16 emergency hospitalizations, 12 cases of chronic bronchitis, and 12 asthma emergency room visits. In dollars and cents, this translates to $149 million in healthcare costs.
Appreciate your ride.
Thank you.
I think our main goal today is to really show the solidarity of the folks of Boston and all the communities around for the people of Salem and what they have to deal with. And we just really want to raise awareness and show the solidarity and really actually ask the governor to continue on his path of, you know, his promise of renewable energy. And he says that he would like to see Salem move away from a coal-based power plant.
It's all of you who rode here today. You can add your energy and your voices for a coal-free future. I love your t-shirts. and for clean energy. We thank you for joining in this effort.
And thus I am glad to see that today, after nearly 60 years, finally the plant is seeing the future, that it may not stay here. And I, for one, will be very happy to see it go.
Everybody ready?
Ready.
From the stacks of old smoky are pouring out soot from the harbor of Salem
to the towns of
Hollywood. The guys who make profits for genius dominion are running their business like hard-hearted men. They are sending out poisons and pollutants to boot.
Certainly in this 5-year horizon, we would expect Salem Harbor plant to shut down. We will not invest